So here we have then power plants and their capacity. A power plant's capacity is its power rating, and that is its maximum power that's available at any particular moment when it's turned on and running at 100%. So power plants are often named with their capacity next to their name. So for instance, we have the Byron Generating Station, a nuclear power plant, that has a 2,300 megawatt capacity. We have the Hoover Dam, a hydroelectric facility, with a 1,039.4 megawatt capacity. The Shearer Power Plant, which burns coal, has a very large 3,406.7 megawatt capacity. And the Sweetwater Wind Farm in Texas with a 241 megawatt capacity. Power rating is often expressed in megawatts using the capital M and W as an abbreviation. Don't be surprised if you see megawatts of electric capacity, that is capital M, capital W with a small e. Both of them mean the same thing, and that's simply a power plant's capacity. In either case, we need to remember that mega means 1 million. So a million is 60, so 1 megawatt is 1 million watts. So if we go back up to the Byron Generating Station, we can say that the Byron Generating Station has a 2,300 megawatt capacity, and it's just as correct to say the Byron Generating Station has a 2,300 million watt capacity. Either of those are correct. It's simply more convenient to say megawatt capacity. So if we use this information, we can then look at any power plant around the world and see what its capacity is. If we then determine how much electricity is generated from these power plants, we have to introduce a unit of time. Time is essential to understanding generation, and notice then that we've got not just the power plant's capacity listed, but when we talk about actual generation, we always use an hour symbol, so capital M, capital W, small h. The unit of time is an essential part of understanding how much electricity has been generated. Now, to do this, it's a simple multiplication problem. It's nothing more complex than that. So again, using the Byron Generating Station as an example, we have its capacity of 2,300 megawatts. And if we run that plant at 100% for 24 hours, we simply multiply its capacity by 24 hours, and we get an electric output of 55,200 megawatt hours. Notice again, the hours is included there. We can't talk about electricity generation unless a unit of time is included. We can then extend this 24-hour day out over, say, an entire year. And the same procedure works in this case. In this case, though, instead of using 24 hours, which are the number of hours in a day, we use 8,760 hours. That's the number of hours in a year. We again multiply the capacity, 2,300, by then the number of hours in a year, 8,760, and we get a generation of 20,148,000 megawatt hours. We can do this same procedure with any power plant on the planet. So for example, number two, we have the Sweetwater Wind Farm, having a much smaller capacity than the Byron Generating Station, but the same procedure applies when we ask, well, how much electricity is generated over a year? So if we operate the Sweetwater Wind Farm for an entire year at 100% capacity, perfectly generating electricity over that entire year, it will then generate 2,111,160 megawatt hours. Now in both these cases, remember, I assume that we're running these plants at 100% and perfectly generating electricity for that entire unit of time. Reality, though, is that no power plant ever experiences perfect generation. It's impossible. In the case of a nuclear power plant, reactors have to be taken down in order to be refueled and inspected for safety. And of course, with wind, well, if the wind doesn't blow, then no electricity is generated. So there's an additional issue that we have to consider when we're looking at how much electricity a power plant generates. It's more than just its capacity. It's more than just its unit of time. It also must include something called capacity factor. And that's what we'll consider in the next presentation.